It's Merry Christmas from your Uncle Joker.
I remember the first time I saw him. I had this feeling of shock and awe, disgust and intrigue. But most of all, I had this feeling that I was watching a man with no fear. This is the story of the real-life Joker on Omegle, who goes by the name Gypsy Crusader.
Well, hello, beautiful. Oh, do I look like a clown? At least I'm not dressed up like a woman. How old are you? What is fine? Where are your parents? Do you really believe that stupidity that you just said? How about a magic trick? Do I really look like a guy with a plan? I'm gonna make. Are you a little bitch? This black person. Are you retarded? Disappear. You know who Jeffrey Epstein is? Pick a card. A king has met his jester. You sure? I don't know if you're gonna like it. What an asshole. You're a n***. White power. How come he's not out looting with all of his homies? Do you speak taco, motherfucker? Are you a sand a camel jockey? A magic carpet salesman?
Whites only.
Why don't you go back to the desert and blow yourself up, Allahu Akbar style? Why are you gay? Maybe you'll get AIDS on the way. Wooga 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 wooga. What's your relationship like with your father? Why so serious? Africa is a shithole. How insulting. I'm offended. The Holocaust isn't real, fucking piece of shit. What's wrong? Does the Joker have your tongue?
You're a scum.
Hey. Let me slow you down. You want to play this game?
You're going to hell.
Maybe I'll see you on the way down.
You must be a Trump supporter because you are a clown.
You must be a Trump supporter because you are a clown. Why don't you learn how to speak English? I'm a fascist. I'm not a Republican. Don't talk like one of them. You're not. I don't want to vote for either party because I just want both sides to fight. I don't give a shit. To them, you're just a freak. Like me.
Don't be stupid. Be a smarty. Come and join your Nazi party.
Are you against abortion?
Yes. It's okay. Gather yourself.
Because it's racist.
Oh, it's racist.
Are you part of the KKK?
Me? No, I'm not part of the KKK, but I do like them. I admire their work. What'd you say, you dumb fucking fake gangster?
You're an odd guy, racist trooper.
N***er. You're a n***er. You're a n***er. N***er. And that's how we reached a youth.
For those that are unaware, there are many chat sites like Chat Roulette and Omegle, which people use to video chat with random strangers on the internet. Almost every day, Gypsy Crusader will put on a costume, log on to a chat site, and proceed to spread his beliefs. He will say, and often shout, racist and hateful things to anyone who will listen. He then records these interactions and streams them out to his followers. He isn't the first person to do this.
Yeah, I'm very sick right now.
But what makes Gypsy Crusader different is that he is not doing this anonymously.
My name is Paul Miller. Paul Miller. My name is Paul Miller. People know me as Gypsy Crusader.
You may find this atrocious or humorous. His work may appear to intentionally shock or make people laugh, but make no mistake, everything Gypsy Crusader says, Paul Miller believes.
Oh, what's wrong? What are you scared of, Nazis?
All of these racist, sexist, homophobic, and generally rude things that Paul says, he is 100% serious about.
You think I'm joking, right? You think I'm fucking around? I'm not. I'm dead serious. It's absurd that we allow blacks and Jews to hold political office in America. This is a white country. That's why I preach white power.
He is a supporter of a growing Nazi movement in the United States and believes in white supremacy. Some of you may have the same question that I did.
Why
you do what you do?
I just want to know where the hate comes from. I'm intrigued.
What compels someone to do this and believe these things? Who is Paul Miller? And why did he become Gypsy Crusader?
Hello, my name is Paul Miller, and this is my story.
Before we talk about Paul, we need to talk about a group called Antifa. Antifa stands for anti-fascist. They frequently hold events and participate in protests to oppose racism and fascism. While this is an understandable goal, over the past few years, this group has been getting increasingly more aggressive with their methods of achieving it.
Last night, a group of people who describe themselves as anti-fascists took to the streets, and I watched as one person smashed the store's ATM.
One tactic that is used by many activist groups, including Antifa, is doxing. Doxing is the practice of making someone's personal details public. Names, relatives, phone numbers, email, mailing address, residency. In an online setting, these details often invite harassment onto the people who are doxed. And this is what happened to Paul. Paul Miller was once a normal guy. He was a conservative, but would never post any hateful terms or advocate for white nationalism. He worked at a gas station and spent most of his time as a professional Muay Thai fighter, and a pretty good one too.
My name is Paul the Gypsy Miller. I'm from New Brunswick, New Jersey.
Round one!
Let's go, Gypsy!
The word Gypsy comes from his Romanian heritage and symbolizes the resourcefulness and fighting spirit of the Romani immigrants. Paul's trainer was a big influence on his life, and he often mentions him when talking about fighting.
My trainer, the man who trained me, he told me like this once. He said, out of 100 people, you will train 100 people. One of them will be like you and go all the way and fight in an actual ring and make a career out of it.
As Paul got older, he eventually took up an interest in politics. However, he was displeased with mainstream media outlets, believing them to be untrustworthy and manipulative. He started to become more active in the community, learning about political figureheads of different movements on all sides of the spectrum. Eventually, this led Paul to seek out a gathering of the Metropolitan Republican Club in October of 2018. This was an event that featured right-wing political speakers, one of which was Gavin McInnes, a comedian and founder of the controversial group, the Proud Boys. Because of this, he draws in many crowds of both supporters and protesters. When Paul arrived, he found that the event was sold out. But instead of leaving, he noticed there was a group of protesters outside. Paul believes that many of them were members of the Antifa group and begins to film them. One man notices this, walks up to Paul, and knocks his phone out of his hand. There is a small altercation, but nothing serious before the police arrive. Much later, as the Republican event is coming to a close, Paul is walking with a friend of his. He notices the same person who assaulted him earlier approaching, surrounded by other menacing individuals. He tells his friend to run, and she escapes as he is attacked by more than five individuals.
It was just a crowd of about maybe 70, 80 Antifa members screaming and chanting and wild like animals out front of the Republican Club. As I was fighting with them, I dropped my bag, and five more of them came. These are in black masks, in black clothes. They looked so scary, dangerous.
Paul defends himself with his Muay Thai training long enough for the police to arrive, and they arrest the attackers.
They started trying to assault the police officer, screaming at the police officer, screaming at me, I'm a Nazi. It was unbelievable, something out of a movie.
And you're not a member of the Proud Boys or a member of the Republican Club. You just went as a spectator to see it.
No, I'm not a member of the Proud Boys. I just went there to see.
However, despite video evidence and eyewitnesses, the DA let them go. This was a huge blow to Paul, and he demanded justice, but found none. After this disappointing outcome, Paul starts becoming more radicalized, going to events and even attending protests. He starts posting increasingly antagonistic pictures on Instagram. Members of Antifa see these and proceed to dox him. Suddenly, Paul is getting calls and emails from people harassing him and threatening him. They start calling his work and eventually get him fired from the gas station. Then they go after his Muay Thai gym. They call and harass his trainer until eventually he gives in and tells Paul that he is no longer welcome at his gym. After 7 years of working together, Paul and his trainer were parting ways. Then the activist went after his family, calling his mother and father, protesting outside their house, and even getting the FBI involved.
It's actually with the FBI, man. We need to speak to Paul. Where is he now?
Paul was shook. It seemed like his whole life had been ripped away from him. But instead of backing down, Paul embraced his Romani heritage and fought even harder. He kept the name Gypsy, but added something more. He added his newfound hatred.
Madness is like gravity. All it takes is a little push. My opinions on BLM? They should all be lined up against the wall and shot. The foreskin pirates. You want HIV, My name is Paul Miller,
How do you feel about Asians?
They like to eat bats. Oh, it's racist? What's racist about it? Do I look like someone that's here to fucking amuse you? Even to a guy like me, that's cold. It's so sad that you judge a book by its cover.
This brings us to today. You can still find Paul actively live streaming his beliefs. Although the Joker is his most popular persona, he actually does several other characters, including the Riddler, the Punisher, Harvey Birdman, and even the Prophet Muhammad.
Allahu Akbar!
I've been looking for you all night, Batman. Riddle me this before you go. I am loud and obnoxious. I like music that rhymes. I'm a fraction of the population, but commit half the crimes.
You might think he is alone, but that is far from the truth. Despite being banned on mainstream sites, Paul has thousands of active followers on his alternative social media accounts, and more join all the time. When he live streams, he consistently gets more than 1,000 watchers. And remember, he does this almost every day. More recently, people have been seeking out Gypsy Crusader, and Paul will often greet his audience and fans with white power and a Roman salute.
Gypsy Crusader.
White power?
White power. Joker.
Brother.
White power.
White power, man.
Wait, I've seen that guy on TikTok.
Oh, have you seen me on TikTok?
Let's get a good screen cap for the boys. White power.
White power, brother.
Yeah, that's
my word,
man.
Yeah.
I'm in love with you.
All the girls love Joker. King!
Thanks, brother. Love you, man.
I know you on the internet. You're notorious. I've heard about you, man.
What's up, brother?
My man.
He also recently started another YouTube channel that talks about fitness and teaching people about fighting.
So you know where your hands are.
It seems like for the foreseeable future, this is what Paul will continue doing. He still faces harassment from his opposition and even conducts harassment of others.
I would absolutely dox people like you. People like you need to be taught a lesson. You need to be taught a lesson. You need to be fired from your job. You need to be ostracized from society.
I have successfully pissed off the entire white nationalist side of Instagram.
Remember that this is all to further the cause of violence and the escalation of a second American Civil War that Paul wishes to see in his lifetime. Even out of character, he talks a lot about these kinds of things.
A civil war is almost, it's almost inevitable. I did this because it was the only outlet that I saw that was possible to fight back. Then I realized, well, okay, the left has their terrorists, which are the communists. Well, who's the right's terrorists? The fascists. We're the terrorists on our side. What I tell people to do is try to accelerate doubt in the system. Now, I just want to see the two sides fight each other until they're weak. My job is to fan the flames. We must find a way to get some kind of conflict or some kind of system collapse. And you're never going to cut through it, brother, with political ideology. Oh, my idea is better than your idea. That's why I use race, because it cuts right to the point and it cuts through all of the bullshit.
But it's important to remember that Paul is just a person like any of us.
It's hard to tell people, you know, I don't want to tell people to throw their lives away. I don't want to tell people to do that because I could be wrong. I could be wrong about everything. And anybody who gets close to me gets hurt. It happened already a few times. They try to hurt the people who get close to me. So I try to keep my distance from everybody.
My family, they worry about me all the time. My parents call me all the time. They call me. They're always worrying that something's going to happen to me. Someone's going to try to hurt me. Someone's going to try to kill me. And I feel bad. I feel horrible. It hurts me. You know, and it hurts me bad. But yeah.
I miss fighting. Fighting was great, man. I used to live for fighting. It was a simpler life.
I miss it very much. People think I like this? Where he's like, oh, you must get an ego boost when you see a meme of yourself. I don't. I don't even really like it. It's weird. I was such a normal I was such a normal guy. I think back on it. When I was fighting, like when I was training, when I was fighting, I didn't think about none of this shit. I didn't care about any of it. Everybody kind of knows who I am. Everybody sees me. Everybody likes my stuff, which is great. I love you. I appreciate it. I appreciate it so much. But I don't know anybody. I don't know them. So it just feels weird.
This video isn't intended to promote or support Paul Miller's work. This video is an investigation into understanding hatred. I think there's a lot we can learn from Paul's story. A lot of times, when people get radicalized, it is because they have been ostracized by other communities or even their own. This clashing of ideals in our current political climate does come with some casualties. Regular people can be hurt, and those that survive, like Paul, become stronger and gather more hatred towards their opposition. There is one thing that Paul says a lot that really makes me think whenever he says it. That this could happen to anyone.
I don't have many friends these days. It, changes your perspective on things, you know? Because we're all just one bad day from being just like me.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching. I just have a few announcements. First off, sorry about the video being a day late. I know I usually post on Sunday, but this video just kind of spiraled out of control. Honestly, I've been doing a lot of research and editing. My brain's kind of fried at this point, so sorry if I come off lethargic in this kind of exit scene. If anyone's new to my channel, I usually post videos every Sunday. However, I'm taking the next couple weeks off, so I want to spend some time with some family, work on some personal skills like software skills, sound design, editing, things like that, so I can make better videos for you guys. So there will be no video this next Sunday or the following one. Some video specific announcements. I know I've said this over and over and it's at the beginning of my video, but please do not harass Paul or his followers, especially if you're adamantly opposed to what he does. You shouldn't do it because it only seems to add fuel to the fire. So please do not harass anyone on the internet. Always be kind and respectful to one another. Some notes about the video. I did a lot of research into this. However, most of the information that I got came straight from Paul himself. I only say that because if people want to research this topic further, I encourage you to do so. Once again, don't harass anyone, but feel free to research yourself. And there's still lots more that can be done on this topic. Lastly, I have a sneaking suspicion that this video is going to be a little more popular than some of my other ones. So if you have any questions, I leave my comment section completely open. So questions can go down there and I'll try to answer as many as I can. If there are a lot of questions, then I might make a video like a Q&A video on the topic later. All right, that's all for now. I hope everybody has a great holiday break and I will see you in a few weeks.